education. So I did my bachelor's in India, and I was looking for a higher education in the country. So I applied for my master's here in the United States for different colleges, and I was accepted in one of those, so I came here. That was my first time ever getting on a plane. So the ride was smooth, but like, you know, my nerves were railed enough. The flight time was around 18 to 19 hours. By the time you take into all the breaks and layovers, it'll probably be like 26, 27 hours. So more than a day, yeah. And then, like, you know, it's 12 hours off. You lose 12 hours when you're traveling to the United States. So effectively, it'll be like a 36.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it is crazy. Mm-hmm. So different. The education system is different. You know, you don't grow up as fast as you grow up here in this country, right? Like, you know, so at the age of 18, you're still considered a kid in India. Here, you know, at the age of 15, you get started to treat as an adult. My parents living in India, my sister lives in India, so we do go back to India every year. So yeah, all of my family is still in India. Some of my cousins are here, but my immediate family, my parents and my sister, both of them are in India. That was my first visit to the country. So I did send an email to some of my seniors who were already in Ole Miss. I came to Ole Miss, University of Mississippi, 60 miles down south from here. I did send an email to some of my seniors who are from pretty much the same city, same state where I came from in India. So I came through some acquaintances that there are a couple of seniors who are actually doing their masters in Ole Miss. So I was able to get hold of their email address and then send them an email saying that, hey, I'm coming in August of 1996. So they kind of took care of me. So they came to the airport, they picked me up, they came in and they showed me around. They made sure I got into a nice apartment, like, you know, shared with a few other friends. So, you know, they did that for any people who are coming from India. So I did the same thing for any of the future generations coming in. So it was kind of like, you know, an unwritten rule that you got to help the people who are coming from India, just like the help that you received in the past, right?
Yeah,
if not for that, like, and if not for that kind of support, it would be very tough for like an 18-year-old leaving the country for the first time and walking into a completely different culture. I am really thankful. I still remember those two gentlemen who actually came and picked me up from the airport. The first time I ever saw them, you know, we did not have telephones at the time. We did not have cell phones where I could just give